me to introduce myself. The name is Smith. I'm a private eye. And while I can tell you that, what I can't tell you is what I was doing on this dark, rainy street on the wrong side of the tracks. And I especially can't tell you what that giant octopus was doing in the street in front of me, wearing a fedora at that. Sure, the streets were wet, but a giant sea creature here on land and in this part of town, it didn't add up. You don't ask questions when a massive mollusk comes towards you, its breath reeking a squid. Now, I usually like squid when I'm sitting in a Japanese restaurant. But here on this dark, lonely street, its titanic tentacles gripping my throat, I was not so much in the mood for said aroma.
"You better come with me. The boss wants to see ya," he said.
Now when an oversized cephalopod grabs you and beckons you to go see the boss, you comply. Well, there he was, in a darkened warehouse space. The gargantuan mollusk in the corner. And I came face to face with the big man. Now you don't want to see the boss under any circumstances, you dig? Under any circumstances. But especially not with an immense octopus in the room eyeing you menacingly and breathing the odor of inky invertebrates in your general direction. Good thing I had a pouch of Big League Chew in my pocket. Everybody loves Big League Chew. I took a big handful and stuffed it in the gullet of the octopus, right underneath his beak. And as he began to chew, the bubble gum, the pink bubble started to emanate not only from his mouth, but also from his suction cups on his tentacles. He blew up like a giant pink balloon and floated higher, higher out of a hole in the ceiling and off to the moon. So it was just me and the boss. And I realized right then and there that with his protection gone, the boss was a mere puppet. And when I say puppet, I'm not being figurative. I'm being literal. A marionette puppet. Craning my neck upward into the shadows, I saw on a rafter above a tiny mouse holding the strings of the marionette. Luckily, I had a rubber band in my back pocket. I pulled it out and shot it ceilingward at the solar plexus of the rodent, who plummeted to his dusty demise on the floor at my feet. He looked up, breathing his last gaspy breaths, and said,
"Avoid a life of crime and stay in school."
When a dying puppeteer mouse tells you to do that, you heed his words. I matriculated at Ohio State, got a master's in library science, and the rest, as they say, is history. So tell me, bub, do you want to pay your library fines now or later? Eventually, you gotta pay.